The activity we're going to be doing today uses a blender, and a blender has really sharp blades. So it's important to make sure you have a grown-up assistant for today's activity. Hello, friends. My name is Alissa, and I'm the Science Program Manager at Boston Children's Museum. I'm part of the STEAM team. STEAM stands for Science, Technology, Engineering, Art, and Math. And today we're going to be using all of those things together to recycle some old paper to make new paper. Paper is one of the easiest things to recycle, and it's so easy, you can even do it at home. Here's the materials that you'll need for today's activity. Paper, like used up copy paper or printer paper, newspaper, shiny paper like from ads or magazines, but construction paper doesn't work very well. Nylon stockings, a wire hanger, water, and old rags or towels. Here's a few things that you can use if you want to. A rolling pin, an iron and ironing board, and a hairdryer. Okay, the first thing you'll need to do is take your wire hanger and bend it into kind of a diamond shape, and then stretch the nylon stocking over it. Then you'll need to take your paper and rip it up into small pieces, about 1 inch square. Like I said, you can use copy paper. I've got a whole bunch of paper that I've scribbled on already. You can use newspaper. You can use ads that you get in the mail. You can use magazines. Construction paper, not so much. So, after you've ripped up your paper, put it into your blender so that your blender is about halfway full. It looks, I've got a tiny little bit left. I'll just throw it in there. Okay, then you're going to add water a little bit at a time using your blender in between pours until you get a nice soupy pulp. When you use the blender, it's really important that you hold the top down. Okay, ready? Once you've got a good pulpy mixture, you can add a few things to spice up your paper. You can throw in a little pinch of glitter or a few larger pieces of colorful paper. You can even put in some flower seeds. If you decide to put any of these extras in, just dump them in there and give a couple quick pulses on your blender. You don't want to get them all mushed up into the pulp. The next thing you'll need to do is set up your nylon stocking screen on top of a colander or a bowl. And it's a good idea to do this in the sink just in case you get some spilling. Then take your pulpy soup and pour it over your screen. Try and pour it evenly, because this will be the approximate shape and size of your paper when you're done. If it doesn't come out quite even, don't worry. You can use a spatula to spread it out, shape it up a little bit. It's kind of like spreading frosting. And then once you've got it all set up, you're going to leave it alone for at least 30 minutes. While your pulp is draining, you'll want to set up a few rags or old towels. Just lay them out on the counter, because once your pulp is drained, you'll need to flip it out onto one of these towels to keep on drying it. The other thing you can do while your pulp is draining is wash out your blender. I guess I'll see you in about 30 minutes. Okay, it's been a little while. I cleaned out my blender, I had some lunch, and I think my pulp is about ready to be dried out. So I'm going to take this towel and very gently press it into the pulp here. My next step is to take this screen over to the other end of the counter where I have a towel laid out and flip the pulp out onto that towel. Now I'm just going to keep pressing down with fresh towels to get this to keep on drying. A rolling pin can make this a little easier. At this point, my paper is pretty dry, so I have a few choices. I can just let it sit and let it dry on its own. I can go get a hairdryer and dry it that way, or I can iron it. I actually kind of like to iron, so I'm going to do that. This is another part of the activity that definitely needs grown-up help. Kids can iron, it's okay, but you'll want an adult around just to keep an eye on things. So you can see I've got my paper here. I'm going to lay another towel on top of it and start ironing. Here's my finished product. I tore the edges off a little bit to make more of a rectangle shape. And if you look closely, you can see little colored dots from where I colored on the original paper with magic markers. If you decided to put flower seeds in your paper, you can write a letter on it and send it to somebody and tell them that when they're done, they can rip up their paper and plant it to grow some flowers. I hope you enjoyed today's activity, and keep checking back here on Facebook, Instagram, and YouTube for more fun things to try at home. Thanks for joining me today.